This land has a name today and is marked on maps. But the names and the marks and the land all had to be won. Won from nature and from primitive man. 5 generations ago, a mere 125 years back, this land was known only as the West, known only to a handful of white men, lonely trappers wandering its vastness in search of beaver. They were known as mountain men, a new breed, men like Jim Bridger, Frenchy Sublette, Linus Rawlings, more Indian than the Indians in all but blood. They held to no law but their own, drifted free as the clouds, settled nowhere, kept forever on the move, their moccasined feet and unshod horses leaving no trace on the land. Like the Indians with whom they were at peace, they wanted nothing beyond what they found, and little of that. The mountains, the forests, the harsh country were as unchanging to them as the stars, and just as unyielding. Far behind the mountains, beyond the rolling plains, they had left the people of the East, people who were restless in another way, the kind who'd look at a mountain and see a watershed, look at a forest and see lumber for houses, look at a stony field and see a farm. Their faces and their instincts had been turned to the West ever since Plymouth Rock and Jamestown. The trapper's road was the trail of a wolf or the bend of a canyon. But for whole families, chafing to follow the sun, there had to be broader ways. There were no roads into the wilderness, only rivers. And they flowed in the wrong direction, north or south, or else they stopped at the Alleghenies. Until one day, a new river took source in the mind of a man named DeWitt Clinton. He conceived of a river that would go west. And in the way Americans have of acting out their dreams, it came to be. The Erie Canal left the Hudson above Albany and carried clear across to the Great Lakes. People who yearned for virgin land and a new life now had a highway to take them, and they moved along.
Pride of Utica now loading! All aboard for the Pride of Utica!